Class we had discussed about the sequence of our 10 types of paramitas. So how the sequence has been made in our class, so we had discussed it. So today we are going to discuss what are the characteristics, what are the functions, what are the proximate cause and manifestations. So in our later Buddhist text, Pali text especially, for any concept or any term, there are four things which have been given for understanding of any concept. They are Lakkhana, Rasa, Paccupatthana, and Padatthana. Through this, any concept can be defined in a very clear manner, and understanding of any concept can be done. So in our last class, we had discussed the definitions of the parami, what is parami, how it has been defined in the text, and what is the sequence of the six paramitas or 10 paramitas we had discussed in our last class. Today, we are going to discuss that what are the characteristics of our paramitas and how it has been discussed in a very detailed manner. So we'll discuss one by one. So we have already seen that there are only six main paramitas or parmi, or in English it is called as perfections, which are known as human values, which take a being from the state of suffering to the state of eternal bliss. There are six main paramitas: dana paramita, sila paramita, Dan Paramita, Sil Paramita, Shanti Paramita, Priya Paramita, Dhyan Paramita, and Prajna Paramita. And then we had also seen that how in our Pali text, such as Adhitthan, Upekkha, and Mitta, these four have been added. And there are 10 types of perfections which have been discussed. And in our last class, we had discussed the definitions of the 10 types of perfections. That what is the Dana Paramita, what is Sila Paramita, Shanti Paramita, Virya Paramita, Dhyana Paramita, Prajna Paramita, Sach Paramita, Adhitthana Paramita, then Upekkha Paramita, and lastly, we had discussed about the Metta Paramita. So these are the 10. Now we are going to discuss what are the characteristics of these 10 types of perfections and what are the functions. Rasa, what are the manifestations, Paccupatthana, and what are the immediate cause of these 10 types of perfections. So let us discuss one by one. As we have already seen that Dharana Paramita is that type of perfections which is related with the act of generosity. Whenever we give something to someone, that if a person gives any charity, then it dispels the, you can say, greediness. That until unless you are having rag and nandi, that is the lust and attachment. Lust is the rag and attachment is the rag is the attachment and lust is called as nandi. So whenever we are having any lust with any respective or attachment to any object, this is called as you can say greediness. So it dispels the quality or you can say the nature of the greediness. Whenever we give something to someone, it means that you are removing the act of taking the thing which does not belong to you also. And sometimes we, out of that, we are stealing the things from someone. So this is the main characteristics, that it dispels the quality of our attachment. And if you go through the second noble truth, you will see that all the sufferings are caused by our avidya as well as desire. if you see yayam tanha panubhavika nandi rag sahagata tatra tatra abhinandani setitam kama tanha bhav tanha and vibhav tanha. These are the three types of desires, to related with the sensual pleasures, to remain in this process of repeated existence again and again, and not to remain in this process of repeated existence again and again. These three types of desires, trishna, which are arising again and again, and these are creating suffering. So these are the cause of the suffering. So whenever you are giving something to someone, you are behaving just like that. You are not having any attachment towards any object. So it has the characteristics of relinquish, to get departed from any belongings. That is why even monks are also supposed to take only the things which are sustaining your body. That is why bhikkhus are, or monks are said that they have to take only the things which cover the body. Ghas chadan paramtayo bhikkhu santutto hoti. That a monk is supposed to be get satisfied only covering with the grass and the leaves of the tree. In that way, that only for sustaining of the body you have to take the meal. So dan has the characteristics, you can say, the lakkhana, in the sense that you are relinquished from the your belongings, whatever you are having in your house, whether it is wealth, whether they are clothes and other things. So this is the, you can say, and this is the thing which you can give to anyone. And this is the, you can say, act of prosperity, or you are getting the thing of peace and serenity by giving something to someone. So this is the, you can say, and it has the only, you can say, Paccupatthana, that how you are relinquishing any belongings which are associated with it. So that is the dan, you can say. So dan parvita has the characteristics to relinquish from your belongings, whether they are wealth, clothes, and any rupees or money, whatever you are having. So this has the characteristics of removing from the lust as well as attachments towards your sensual pleasure, to remain in this process of repeated existence again and again, and not to remain in this process of repeated existence again and again. Now we are coming to the sīla pāramitā. We have already discussed that what is the sīla and what is sīla pāramitā. Sīla pāramitā is the name of the perfections through which we are curtailing the physical as well as vocal misdeeds. There are three types of physical misdeeds: panatipata, adinnadana, kamesu mikchachara. And there are four types of vocal misdeeds, namely musavada, pisunavacha, farusavacha, and sampalapa. So seal is the name of the removal or curtailment of the three types of physical and four types of vocal misdeeds. That is the dosil. That is the bad contact related with the physical and the vocal misdeeds. Now, what is the characteristics of that? What is the lakkhana? So, Acharya Buddha goes in the text Visuddhi Magga, says that sīla has the characteristics of composing. That is the sīlana. Then again, there is a question, kim idam sīlanam? What is that sīla, sīlana? Silan is in the sense of samadhan and upadharanam. What is the samadhan? Coordination. What is the coordination? That kai kam adinam susilya vasena avikappinitati yatho. That silan is in the sense of the coordination of the physical and vocal actions which are associated with the bad conduct, and there must be inconsistency of the physical and the vocal misdeeds. So that is the samadhan, you can say. And what is upadharanam? Upadharanam is called as kusalanam dhammanam patiṭṭhāna vasena adhāra bhāvoti yato. That here upadharana is the name of the base of the establishment of the moral dhammas. That so here seal paramita has only two characteristics. That is the samadhan, coordination of the bad conduct related with the physical and the vocal actions, as well as inconsistency with the physical and vocal actions. Second is the upadharana, that is the, it is sila parvita, gives the base of the establishment of the moral dhammas. Kusalanam dhammanam patiṭṭhāna vasena adhāra bhāvoti yato. So this is the, it has the, you can say, characteristics. Now, what is the rasa? Ras means function. What is the function of the sila parvita? If a person who performs virtue or the morality, what are the functions of that? Function of the sila parvita is to dispel or destroy the physical and the vocal misdeeds or curtailment. Lakkhana or characteristics is the sìlana. A sìlana is of two types, samadhana and upadharanam, coordination of the bad conduct as well as the inconsistency with the physical and vocal actions, and upadharana, that is the base of the establishment of the moral dhammas. But the function of the sila parvita is the only curtailment of the physical and vocal misdeeds or immoral actions. Like panatipata, adinnadana, kamesumichachara, musavada, pisunavacha, farusavacha, savfalapa. And now the question arises that what are the manifestation and immediate cause of the sila parvita? Whenever a person who performs the sila parvita, what are the manifestation? Paccupatthana and Padatthana, that is the immediate cause. Blameless is the name of the socheya. Blameless is the manifestation of the sila parvita. If a person who performs the sila parvita, that blameless, anyone cannot blame the person who is following the seal. So that has the manifestation. And what are the immediate cause of the seal? Acharya Buddha Ghosh says that Hiri and Ottappa, these are the two dhammas or states which are the immediate cause of the sila paramita. What are the Hiri and Ottappa? Hiri is the feeling self-same, and Ottappa is the social same. What is the self-same? That atgarvena papam jahati iti hiri, that feeling self-same at the time of doing something immoral, that is called as hiri. That is called as self-same. And what is the social same? That is another name of lokalajja. And this is called as pargarvena papam jahati iti utappam. That what the people of the society will think about me if I commit any immoral things, if I kill a person, if I steal anything, what the people of the society will think about me. This type of lokalajja or social shame, this is called as utappa. So this sila parvita has immediate cause of the same that is the self-esteem as well as social esteem, hiri and otappa. Now we are coming to the next, that is called as renunciation or nekhamma paramita or neskarma paramita. That we have already seen that nekhamma paramita is that type of perfections through which a person renounces the household life and takes a life of recluse after hearing the teachings of the Buddha, and he joins the order, that is the Buddha Sangha, and he takes the Tisarana, Buddham Saranam Gacchami, Dhammam Saranam Gacchami, and Sangham Saranam Gacchami. These three types of Tisarana is being taken by a person who has renounced the household life. So this is called as renunciation. So what are the characteristics of that renunciation? This is the definition, sìlparamita. But what is the, you can say, characteristics, lakkhana, that it has the characteristics of departing from your household life and taking a life of recluse. So what is, does it mean? That you are removing the sensual pleasure. And in the Dhammacakkappavattana Sutta, we also know there are two types of extremes, kamesu kamsu kullikani yogo, association with the sensual pleasure, or association with the pleasure which are being experienced by our senses, and atkilmathana yogo, association related with the self-mortifications. So this renunciation has the characteristics of departing from the household life and taking a life of recluse. It gives the, you can say, it removes the sensual pleasure, association with the sensual pleasure, as well as what is the function of that. It function is that unsatisfactoriness, that you have to verify that what is the unsatisfactoriness related with the, that. So there is no light. So let us see, Wi-Fi is working. So this has the characteristics that what you have to verify unsatisfactoriness, that unsatisfactoriness leads towards the desire, kamatana, bhautana, and vibhautana. And when you are you can say satisfied, then there is no need of kamatana, bhautana, and vibhautana. So renunciation is the name of, you can say, to verify their unsatisfactoriness. And what is the image, manifestation, Paccupatthana? It has the withdrawal from them, withdrawal from the sensual pleasure as well as self-mortifications. And what is the proximate cause? That is the Paccupatthana. It has the a sense of spiritual urgency means saívega. It creates a vibration in your spiritual feeling that how you have to take a life of nirvana, or how you can get a state of eternal bliss. So this neskarma, and there are so many passages in our Pali text. Then some of the lay persons are asking the monks that why did you leave the household life and why did you take a life of recluse? In Milinda Pahyo also, Acharya Nagasen has been asked by King Milinda that why did you take a life of recluse? Then it is said that to remove from the sensual pleasure as well as to have satisfactory satisfiedness in our life, I have taken a life of recluse. So this is the renunciation. Now come to the next. We are coming to the Dan Paramita, Sil Paramita, Chanti Paramita, and then it is called as Prajna Paramita we are coming. So Prajna Paramita, we are also knowing that Prajna Paramita is the name of the perfections or human values through which the right understanding or wisdom can be achieved. And what are the characteristics? We have already defined the Paya is that has the characteristics of enlightenment. Ovasana Lakkhana Paya, Chedana Lakkhana Paya, it has the characteristics to cut off the immoral dhammas. Acharya Buddha Ghosh in Visuddhi Mag defines Paya that it is kusal chitti sampayuttam vipassana yanam ti Paya.